Hello, Sinvicta.
Hello, Northern Lion. How you doing?
Hello. I'm doing well. I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Doing good. It's been a while since we've been here. And whatever the Aaron Lewis lyric is after that in Stained.
Since I was in Addicted.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, we weren't addicted so much to GeoGuessr that we had to miss a week for moving purposes. But I made sure everyone knew that, like, you know.
Yeah.
Already we had the doomsayers. Oh, the series is canceled for the fourth time. I'm like, no.
It is nice that people care. That's the way I choose to interpret it. Is like, you know,
no,
it's a very positive thing that people, they notice that the episodes aren't there.
Yeah, and if people didn't care.
The worst is when you have a series where you forget a couple of days and nobody tells you. Then you're like, nobody's watching this except when they fall asleep and it like autoplays.
But when Isaac is late for like, you know, 5 minutes, oh God, it's the end of the world. It's freaking,
people,
you know,
yeah.
The
rapture outside.
When
it happens
outside.
To me, people think I'm dead. I get tweets. Like, but usually what happens is like, it maybe once every 3 or 4 months, I wake up and there's a post on the subreddit that's like, is he okay? Isaac Slate.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh no.
Or and then you get the philosophers out there. Is NL losing his passion for Isaac? You know, I love all those. But yeah.
It's usually just I set it for 6 p.m. accidentally instead of 6 a.m. in a moment of brain fart.
The fun ones for me are when you release the GeoGuessr videos like 3 hours earlier than what they're supposed to go out. And then I have to explain to my fans out there, they're like, how come you're not releasing yours on time? I'm like, excuse me? I didn't even know.
Oh, have I released them early?
Yeah, you have.
I've released them early. I've released them late. it's me.
But it's fine, though, because actually we get more than any other season. I'm getting a lot of more overlap of people coming
nice.
Over to watch my side, which again, thank you and thank everyone. Who's been watching NL's point of view for coming over and sharing the love as well. And also to people who are posting the ViewSync on the subreddit in the comments, that greatly helps out. But I don't know what the score is. All I know is that NL's up and I'm down. So I think it's 4 or 5 games, something like that. But hopefully a week of moving has made you rusty and old. And I'm hitting the prime of my youth here in GeoGuessr. And I'm ready to go.
Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go.
Good luck. Have fun. I haven't played Geo in what feels like forever, to be honest.
Dude, I'm here to tell you, if we're in Vancouver, you are screwed. Because I was going to say I've been walking the streets, but that's not what I mean to say.
I've been walking the streets and... Apologies, my side. As soon as I got done saying, hey, everyone, thanks for the support here, I actually have to switch browsers again because I'm on Chrome instead of Firefox. So apologies. Keep on going,
you know,
though.
I sound like I'm in a cathedral. I'm looking at a different monitor for half the game now. It's a whole thing.
But how are you liking the new setup, though? It seems like you're a lot happier. A lot more space.
The way I would describe it is like, our old place didn't suck, but it was very, very, very small. In my office, like, literally, I couldn't put my arms out fully outstretched,
yep.
Which is, I know, like, absurd. But no, it's like I didn't know that something was wrong, and now that I'm in a place that has a more normal amount of space,
right.
I just am instantly, it was like a load off my shoulders.
Like, oh, this is how it could be. This is how it should have been for a while. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, it feels, this is normal, and I'm like, oh, that's nice. We have space. But I do, dude, as soon as we're done these Geo episodes, I'm telling you, I'm getting the cordless drill, bunch of screws, this acoustic foam.
Yep. See, I've never actually had, like, sound paneling before, but from everything that I remember TB telling me, it makes a huge difference. Like,
it can,
noticeable.
For sure. Yeah. I think that I kind of took like a half measures.
Right.
I could probably put up some behind me as well, even just for like texturing. But
I mean, you never want to take half measures. We've all seen that Breaking Bad episode.
Exactly. Nobody likes a half measure.
Yeah.
But what I was going to say is I think it does make a big difference for sure. But I haven't put it up properly. I've kind of like a half half-assed it the whole time.
Right.
To use not safe for work language. But, you know, you sound like really good. Like your voice is really isolated.
Really?
I don't know. You got like some rugs or something going on there? You got a carpeted office?
No. I mean, I've got carpet on the floor, but, you know, I've got that smooth Shure SMB7 microphone, and the sound quality has gone up a whole lot. But like, as far as like actually taking measures to keep sound isolated and stuff, I have none. I actually have a fan in the background that's super scratchy
really?
All the time. Yeah,
I can't hear it at all.
Yeah, the noise canceling on the Shure is pretty good.
Dude, I also have to apologize on my end. My monitor is further away. So I actually have to like get out of the frame to look. I'm trying to pull it closer right now, but I have to get out of the frame to look at where it is. Because I can't read the map from this far away.
That's what you get for trying to be an interactive streamer, YouTuber, trying to get a webcam. Look at freaking Mr. Fancy over here on the internet.
Look, I get it, okay? Mr.
I think I know. I've only seen one city name, and I think that's helped me know what the country is, but where, I do not know in this country.
This seems fair. I believe that I am in roughly the right region in the country.
Your guess is also a little bit laggy today, too. I'm not sure if you're...
Yeah, I noticed that as well. The map was not, like, zooming quickly.
Yeah.
Okay. I've got closer than I had any right to get, probably.
Okay, I've got about 40 seconds left, so I'm going to just make a guess here, because I'm pretty sure that my timer continued, but I'm not 100%
sure.
It's
not. I'm not concerned about it. You take as long as you need.
I'm going to go, like, right here, like, just in the tri-state area. I should have stayed up there. Dang it. I was actually way up there to start with. Yeah, because I was near Nevada or whatever that was. Yeah, so you got me by about 700.
Okay.
You gotta love those finish guesses.
For a country that big, yeah, it's not that bad, honestly. Dude, can I tell you something, Sinvicta?
You can, Northern Lion.
We had furniture being delivered today.
Yep.
And when it's heavy. Like, it's some heavy stuff.
Like heavy
deliverers
metal.
Were carrying it in. They were like, sometimes it was all good. When it was not all good, they went pare, pare, and I was like, "Oh, my geoguesser has informed me that you are speaking Portuguese."
Life is bleeding into art, and art vice versa. My God, you're like, "Hey, I know where one of your countries are on the map."
I know, probably shouldn't. Excuse me. I know where both Portugal and Brazil are on the map. Thank you very much. Those are two very easy countries to identify.
I went to Fogo de Chão over the week, earlier this past week, and I'm like, every time I go there, I'm like, man, if only I could speak Portuguese to these people, get a discount or something.
You think so?
But the thing, like, if you think about it, I don't know if you've ever been to. Have you been to Fogo or any kind
of
Brazilian?
I have been to one Fogo de Chão style Brazilian steakhouse.
So it's about $50 a plate.
It was. I would describe it as it's a $3 to $4 sign meal for sure.
Yeah. So, but you when you first hear that, you think like, wow, like $50 a plate, like that's ridiculous. Like, but then you start thinking about it. It's like, well, if I went to like Texas Roadhouse or just name any other chain restaurant out there for $50. Like if you get an appetizer, you get a couple of drinks, you get like, you know, an entree and stuff. You're looking at close to $50 if you include the tip on that.
For sure.
Yeah, and it's like, is it really that bad, you know?
No, I mean, and beyond that, like, let me tell you, I would rather spend, based on the one Brazilian steakhouse meal I've had, I would rather spend like $50. To go to an all-you-can-eat Brazilian steakhouse than like $20 for an all-you-can-eat buffet that sucks.
Yeah.
It's a good mix of like, I mean, obviously you'd eat a lot of food going there, but on top of that, the food is actually good.
Yeah, you get fine cuts. I mean, you get filet mignon, you get bacon wrap stuff, you get my favorite, this stuff called Lombo, and it is Parmesan-encrusted pork tenderloin, and man, that is, you talk about... everyone who goes to Fogo more than once that like has their like their ranks, like their favorites, you know, like, oh, my favorite's the filet, or my favorite's the, you know, the sirloin or whatever. Yeah, the Lombo has always been number one for me. Pretty
Brother,
easy to make at home too.
I'm so confused about this. This doesn't happen very often, but I've seen a top level domain that not only does it make no sense, I cannot think of a country that would have this as their top level domain.
That's bad because I haven't seen it. Although I'm trying to get back to this van who I think has a top level domain on it, but GeoGuessr is moving so slow today. Apologies to my end viewers. I did actually switch to Firefox too.
This has me like seriously concerned because I'm like, this the top level domain that I saw indicates this must be what the country name is in another language. So I have no idea. I've seen text, so I can make a guess, but
I mean, I've seen the. I think we're down here. No, this. This country didn't have like the. No, I'm gonna stick with what I was guessing was over here. I'll say like, I don't know, closer to there. Wow, I should have stayed there, man. I actually went over towards Kosovo and stuff, and I switched it back to Ukraine.
You must have gotten me by a bit then.
I didn't. It's not by that much. Only about by 500. Wow, man. What was the top level domain you saw?
So in hindsight, it does make sense now, but it was .mk.
Oh man. Yeah. We had that like a week ago or 2 weeks
Did
ago.
We?
Yeah. Yeah. Cause we had Macedonia not that long ago.
I think when I like Macedonia, if I see the flag, I'm like, I got it. But, or if I see a city name, probably.
Right.
But just seeing, I was like, we're in Russia. And then I saw .mk and my brain exploded. And I didn't look far enough outside of the Russian, you know, area.
Right.
I didn't go down that far to the southeast.
I knew
so that it
didn't look like Makba levels of Russia.
No.
We're on the outer edge.
That.
I don't know why you guys was moving so slow today. I'm only down by about roughly 200, I'm guessing.
Yeah, that sounds right. I'm at 7303.
I'm at 7112.
Yeah, so roughly 200.
So, the last time, because I realize now how long it's been since we recorded GeoGuessr.
Yeah.
The last time that we recorded, you, Mister, and that freaking New Zealand guess.
I knew you were going to bring it up.
That cements that I will never, ever say anything again. Because so many people are like, Sinvicta, shut up. And I'm like, dude, you gave no indication that you were not on the same page as I was at all.
Yeah. What can I say, you know?
It's this freaking guy.
There is a little gamesmanship involved.
This freaking...
You still won that episode, though.
I did end up winning that one, yes.
And I know because people were like, man, I'm glad Sinvicta won that one. Or he would never forgive himself.
I felt pretty bad. But to be fair, though, and I'm still on the Northern Line defense here. I'm on your side here. If you had been paying attention to the screen there, there was a .nz right in front of you for that entire time.
Oh wow.
And I think that you I'm almost like knowing you, I'm almost 100% sure that you would have noticed that. So
you know what was great is that somebody was like, NL, if you ever want to know whether it's New Zealand, just think like, it does this look like English combined with like Maori language?
Yeah.
And I'm like, brother, that's what Australia looks like to me as a person that doesn't live there as well. It's not that easy.
This is my favorite StarCraft unit right there.
The Firebat.
I'm not saying it. I'm not. I'm done saying proper
names. The Firebat.
Yeah.
Is it the Spider Mine?
Their Friar Shoots.
Jim Rayner.
Jim Rayner. Can you name the unit that Jim Rayner was first seen at?
Yes.
What was he driving?
Absolutely. He was driving a Vulture.
That is correct.
I mean, I was 10 in 1998.
Right.
I played a lot of StarCraft. Like, I played the campaign all the way through using cheat codes, I'll admit, but I was also 10. And I played a little against a friend of mine in LAN.
Right.
Probably played a little bit online and got destroyed, but
I've got these freaking signs here with cities, but I cannot find them for the life of me.
Yes, I would agree with what you're saying.
You would think that this one would be like larger. It would be on the map somewhere.
Stockholm.
No. It's Reykjavik?
My bad. Helsinki. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
I mean, if you ask me anything about StarCraft 2, I wouldn't know. But StarCraft 2 is Kerrigan is now the bad lady.
I got you by 800.
That seems very fair.
It was all the way up there too. Wow. You got to love Swedish guesses.
Yeah,
really any Nordic guesses, period. I mean,
as far as Nordic guesses go, Sweden, Finland, Norway, equal.
Yep.
I do prefer the, and maybe it's not Nordic, but I prefer the guesses because they're just easier. Usually.
The sign is throwing me for a loop, Northern Lion.
Is it?
It is. Because this looks like French, but it's not French.
How do you know that?
Actually, now that I look back and read, I know it's not French.
Really?
Yes.
I don't think so. I'm not playing the game right now, but okay. I'm just going to say it looks relatively French to me.
It's French-like. Yeah, that's more French, okay.
I mean,
Boulangerie?
Oh, that's a bakery.
Boulangerie.
You'll never guess what pharmacy is in French.
Helsinki.
He's absolutely right. It is Helsinki.
I played way too much StarCraft 2.
I believe that.
Played a whole lot. It was back when everyone wanted to be a esports commentator, a la Mathis Games. And you know, it was like, why not? I think I could do it better than the rest of the guys out there. Luckily enough, I was actually a really good StarCraft 2 player, but I say that, but never made it to Grandmaster because that's just insane.
You feel free to disagree with me on this one.
So confused right now.
Because a lot of people do.
Okay.
But I don't understand getting good at a game like StarCraft 2 unless you have a realistic chance to become amazing.
I was going to say, unless you know that you could maybe be the best at it.
Right. Because, this is not to besmirch my good friend Mathis, but like I've, you know, been following his journey into Smash.
I'll besmirch him all I want.
And I'm like, it's like to, he seems frustrated a lot to go through all that hardship just to be like decent. It's like I guess I just don't get it.
You're talking about Smash, not StarCraft.
Yeah,
I got you.
But it's similar with StarCraft. It's like, why would I want to lose when I, instead of losing, I could like win? You know what I mean? I could just be playing a single player game and doing better.
Okay, but my question to you, because I understand what you're saying, right? But then like you play like T99 at what I would say is a pretty high level of skill. Yeah. But do you think that you could become the number one?
Of my games. No, but like it's not. I don't find that game frustrating at all because my win rate is like high. It's 10 times higher than like the average player.
for me, I'm the type of person that I get more frustrated as I get better with a game.
Yeah, that's like, what I mean.
You know, like as my skill increases, the frustration factor increases too. Because then, like, well, I should be this good, or like I've beaten somebody like this good before. You know, and then like you lose to some cheese or you lose to something like that. It's like, I don't know. It kind of sucks out the enjoyment for me. And
that's what I get. I don't get it.
I think that this is the country, but I mean, I know that this is the country, but I don't know where this is. I got the country too late. Oh wow. You were in Italy?
So, dude, like, it was just everything went wrong.
Okay.
So when I saw the city right at the start, I was like, that's Belgium. I know that's Belgium. We've been there. But then I was looking through Belgium. I didn't see any A roads. So I was like, maybe right. It's not. I go into France. Of course, instantly in France, I find A's, the A road.
But they're
I'm
all
following
red.
It. Okay. Yes.
Right.
But I don't know if Google takes the sign color and puts it in the game. And then there's a sign that I got to. It had in hindsight, it was the Belgian flag. But it had what I thought was the German flag, the French flag, and the Italian flag on it. And I just went, okay, I guess I'm gonna try to pick up. So those countries do not share a border. The border is Switzerland, but I guess I'll just try down here near A8, and that's where we ended up.
I can tell that when you said everything just went wrong, I understand the scenario here.
It's the classic GeoGuessr disaster, where you get a piece of information that you think is right, but is right for the wrong reason.
And the worst times
for the right reason.
The worst times for that is that when like the secondary piece of knowledge gets confirmed by something else that also isn't correct. Like,
it
happens. this is the Paris waterworks of Arkansas. You're like, wait a second, and then you see like a French flag. You're like, oh yeah, well, okay. Well, clearly we're in France, and then it's like actually in Arkansas. Mama.
Ooh. But like I want to leave that last part hanging because it sounds like I get the counter argument to it. The counter argument is like, oh, so it's never worth doing anything that's hard, blah blah blah. No, but like, as I've gotten older, I save the stuff that is stressful for real life, like domestic duties and stuff like
moving
that.
Moving and putting together shelves.
Yeah. Well, or like even working out as an example.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I'm never going to become like a, you know, world champion weightlifter or anything like that. And it's hard, but at the same time, like it's worth doing because it'd be actually
you do it for yourself. I mean,
you're improving yourself at the process. Like I just don't. As the older I get, the less patience I have for a video game that makes me upset.
DD Fresh Chicken, your money value.
Mr. What? Chicken. It's the Mr. Chicken supplier.
What in the world? Where are we? So on that last guess, because I know my viewers are going to have some questions too. I of course started at France, and then I was like, wait a second, that looks French, but not quite French. So then I went to nearby Portugal just to look at the streets. And then I was like, this ain't right. So then I was like, oh, well, it's got to be Quebec then.
Okay, now that is...
Well, I wasn't entirely sure, but then I remembered about Belgium. And I was like, oh, it's hang on a second. And then I saw the roads. I was like, yeah, we got color here. It's the same nomenclature and everything. But I didn't get you by that much.
I think at this point you got to be up on me by like 2,000.
I'm at 16,219.
Yeah, roughly 2,000.
This one I feel like this has the makings of a classic. We're gonna bomb at the last second because I have not seen much.
Yeah, I'm in the dark on this one. I'll admit.
Although I wish I would have just gone reverse.
Did you get sucked into the...
No, but I know exactly where we are now.
All right. Well, I can stop pretending I don't then.
Yeah. I had nothing to go on at this point. But then I went in the direction that you went, and you immediately saw that green sign, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So I went down the other road, and there was that the chicken farm, and then just nothing.
Waterworks. Yeah.
Yeah, then nothing. I bet we're right here. If we take a, let's see, we're looking south. So if we take a right, yeah, we have to be at this intersection right here. I'm gonna say right there. No, we were actually like right outside the city. Okay.
Yeah, that's what threw me.
That doesn't
too.
Make any dang sense.
I was like, man, this guy's really confident that in this entire country, he's found the intersection right off the bat.
Well, I mean, I went because I looked at where Francistown was and I saw the direction we were going. I was like, okay, I take a right, we get to Gaborone, we take a left, go Francistown. You'd think it's the first major intersection there, but hey, you know what? I'll take it.
Yeah,
it's good to be back. Sorry about the laggy bits on my end, everyone watching my point of view. I don't know what's going on. I'll close some tabs, I guess, and hopefully it smoothens out a little bit.
Free up some RAM. For now.
Download some more RAM.
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. It's good to be back. We'll be back on Wednesday with another episode. For now, thanks for watching. Thanks for the support. Thanks for missing the series to begin with. Click the like button, subscribe, watching both at the same time. We'll see you next time.
See you later.